seems to me there's not so much houses up here as the estates. A lot of vineyards. But it's a beautiful ride. The vineyards are lovely. Plus, when everybody on the street is a millionaire, they keep the street up real nice. Huh, I love this street. Right by the side of the road. Right, these mansions up on the hill, 10 million, 50 million, I really have no idea. They are magnifico. Timing is good traffic wise because with all these street rides, it is a much nicer ride if there's not a ton of traffic. These street names are a mystery. Virgin Island Road. Does she have to have water to be an island? Up. Gotta get a look at this mosaic. I always enjoy seeing this riding by. Oh my goodness, look at that road. Eagle's Perch, that seems like a reasonable name. Certainly compared to Virgin Islands. I bet there aren't virgins or islands up there. So much landscaping. To pull over to this lane to let the piles of traffic that have backed up behind me on that curvy part get by. So this is absolutely more pleasant. And it was 91 degrees. I'm not complaining about this wind. It is delightful. So this is where we went up West Lilac. We made the big loop. This is that abandoned golf course that I mentioned earlier. I think most golf courses in San Diego are in floodplains. Assume that is the case here, and that's why they just haven't been able to sell the land off to develop it. They could turn it into a big park with bike paths, but for Irvine, I bet that's what they do, because they really understand smart development in Irvine, I gotta say. Very impressive. They build parks and bike paths, and then they develop the land around it, so the houses have a lot of appeal. The area around here is already developed, so I'm not sure there's the same upside for Bonsall turning that into a park. I'm sure they'd rather somebody who's going to pay taxes would take it over, but other than a golf course. Or a park, I'm not sure what it can be if it's in a floodplain. These speed bumps taper off at the edge, in case you're wondering why I'm doing all this swerving. Although, I don't feel like riding into a trash can today. Maybe another day, but not today. When I was riding through Malibu, it was trash day. And it was a tiny bit of fun deciding if I could swerve in between the trash cans or not. Gotta make your fun. So it's 87, we are heading west towards the coast. This should get about a degree cooler every mile. And I'll take it. Plus a ton of wind, which I will also take. It's like an air bath. So to the right over here is the San Luis Rey River, the same one that I take the path down to the beach next to. But up here this time of year especially, it's just a dry riverbed. An aspirational river, as I like to call it. For the most part, when I'm doing a bike ride, I want to do a loop. I'm not an up and back kind of guy, even if it's not quite so interesting. I'd rather be seeing new stuff all the time. But this is Little Gopher Canyon Road, and I am more or less happy to ride up and down it every time I come by, because it's a delight. Runs next to a creek, so it's relatively flat. And it runs into Gopher Canyon Road, which is where I turn around. Because unlike the oh-so-charming Little Gopher Canyon Road, Gopher Canyon Road's kind of a death trap. Very hilly. Not sure if there's a bike path or not. A lot of traffic. Plus you barely notice it, but this is kind of uphill all the way. With the e-bike, you don't really pay that much attention to it. It's not that big a hill, but coming back, it's a little faster and more exciting. Yeah, usually there's traffic. Let's see if I can just slip up here. Get a look at this horsey statue. So that's the creek back there, so they can sit out there on their porch and enjoy the creek. Alrighty, here's our turnaround, because up there is the death trap that is Gopher Canyon Road. Wasn't that nice?